play action. Oh. Johnston, as he's hit, delivers a strike to Hogan. That's number three today for number 80.
Take me through draft day. We turn on SportsCenter. They've got a feature on you, which is crazy. And I think a lot of people expected you probably to be drafted, especially after that feature. So just kind of take me through, you know, what was going through your head throughout the day from the feature to the end of the draft.
So that whole draft day, I was kind of, you know, trying not to let my emotions, take over. But I was watching those later rounds because I knew that's where I was, projected to go if I did get drafted. And, I was hoping that my name was going to get called, but I knew I was one of those on-the-fence guys. It could go either way. You know, when my name wasn't called, you know, I was okay with that. I had some teams calling my agent, calling myself. And at that point, it was just trying to figure out the best fit for me at that time. And me and my agent just worked together. And then, you know, once we decided on the Arizona Cardinals, you know, I was happy to be a Cardinal and just see where that journey was going to take me.
You know, you're getting your story told by the Indy Star and local news outlets, and Sports Center picks up your story. I mean, at what point did you kind of like, well, wow? I mean, this is real. I mean, people are telling my story.
Yeah, it is pretty surreal. I had a lot of teammates once I got to Arizona tell me that they knew who I was just because of that Sports Center feature, and so that was pretty cool. Just for guys to have heard of me, you know, one way or another. You know, it all became, you know, pretty real. Just towards the end of my senior year, and just when scouts were really coming in, and that's when I knew, okay, I gotta do something different and find a way to, you know, not just get to that next level, but find a way to stick, and that's kind of where I'm at now.
You go in with the Cardinals, and you know Larry Fitzgerald obviously plays your position. I think a lot of people kind of wanted to draw comparisons there. I mean, what was he like as a teammate?
He was great. You know, he led by example. He's been doing it for, I think, this is 14 years. And so he doesn't have to do a whole lot of talking. I mean, if you just watch the way he gets things done and the way he practices, you're going to learn a whole lot from him. And then when he does talk, you just got to make sure that you're listening to the tips he's given, because he's seen every coverage, every defense that, you know, a coordinator could throw at him. If I can play, you know, just, you know, half as long as he has at the level he has, you know, that's a good career. So I'm trying to pick up on those little things that have gotten him this far and just implement those into my game.
As far as preseason goes, you get to be on the biggest stage there with that Hall of Fame game, and you had that catch over the middle. Al Michaels calls your name, and that ball is coming to you, and you bring it in. It kind of hits you. You know, you made an NFL catch.
Yeah. That whole game, I really wanted to make a play just because it was the first game, and I wanted to get that play out the way so that I could kind of, you know, stop thinking about it and then just play my game. So that was a big moment, getting that catch, you know, getting hit by a couple, you know, NFL guys and just, just getting out the way.
Things with the Cardinals, you know, I mean, they had a lot of wide receivers on their team. They let you go. You get picked up by the Colts. And, I mean, for a guy already with an awesome story, it gets even better.
Yeah, being in Arizona, that was a great learning experience, and I think I needed that ultimately. People keep asking me if I wish I would have been with the Colts from the beginning, but I think I needed to go to Arizona and, you know, learn from those guys and ultimately, you know, get cut and, you know, have that feeling. And, you know, I had a lot of good moments there. You know, I was covered an onside kick. I had never done that in my career. I played special teams, down to punt inside the five, and so all those were new things. So, you know, after all that and then to get cut and then to be sitting there not really knowing what's next and then to get a call from the Colts and they're flying me in from Florida. That's where I was at after I left Arizona. That was just great. I couldn't have got home any faster. And to tell my family that I was coming home, not just to come home, but to, you know, suit up for the Colts, that was huge. My family was very excited about that. And so now I'm just trying to, you know, see how far I can take this with the Colts, because, you know, I want to be here for a long time.
Madden comes out. Who do you play with in Madden now?
I've actually played one game in Madden, and you played a former teammate here at Marian, Trey White, and he asked me who I was going to be, and I said, I don't know, and he said, you got to be the Colts. And then I was like, yeah. So I ended up playing with the Colts, and I think that was this past week, and I was the Colts, and he was the Browns, just to play the matchup that we were actually getting that week.
Away from the actual field, what's one thing you've learned about being a pro?
Just that even when you're away from the field, you know, you still gotta act like a pro. You know, I still have to watch what I eat. You know, they weigh us in every week, and you know, you try to stay under a certain weight and a certain body fat, and just like sleep. I used to be a guy who It was kind of tough to go to sleep early, and now I'm asleep early every night, and I get up early even on off days. And you know, at least for that season, however long it is, this is going to last, you know, 4 months, this, you know, 17 games. Every day is, you know, you're a pro. Even on off days, you got to go in and watch film. So just trying to figure out my identity on those off days and who the kind of player and guy I'm going to be when I'm away from the field is just what I'm doing right now. But
getting ready for St. Francis, it's another top 10 matchup. Thinking back to your days, what does this game mean to Marian?
This was always the game that you circled on the schedule. Every year I was here, this is the game we looked forward to. Just because, you know, it's that in-state, you know, in-conference team that you know is going to give you everything they got. So I know all the guys are going to be pumped up, and it's a night game this year. So, you know, it's going to feel good outside. You know, all the fans are going to be here. So this is a game that you got to, you know, when you're suiting up, you got to know what you're walking into. And you got to, you know, you got to give it everything you got and play your best on this game if you want to come out with the win.